Got him.
Anybody who's ever fished a frog knows the struggle of a hit. They said hook, and no fish is to be found, just hit and miss. It's one of the most frustrating things you can do as a fisherman, I think.
Got him. Oh, there he was.
But there's a few quick tips you can do to improve your hookup ratio on frogs, and I'm here to tell you them today because there's no fishing. The weather is not looking good. I'm going fishing tomorrow. But at the end of this video, I'll have a couple quick clips of fishing. One I had with Cody the other day, actually. Without the right setup, it makes it a lot more difficult. I'm not saying that you can't fish a frog on a 6'6", medium action, spinning rod like I did till I had a bait caster, and it helps so much. Tall bait caster is what you want. Not good for indoors, you hit the ceilings a lot. Here's a 7.3 Tournament ZX by Cabela's. It's their frog rod. It's only $99. I picked it up and a friend recommended it to me, and I love it, actually. The long rod, even in a kayak, I was kind of hesitant to get it. But the long rod really helps with... this has to be paired up with a high-speed gear ratio on your reel. This is the Shimano Sitica 7.3:1, 7.2:1 gear ratio. And this would be on 40-pound test, 45-pound test. And here I have several different frogs or hollow bodies, I guess. I got a scum frog. I got a spro poppin' frog, whatever that would be called. And then here's a lead target hollow body sunfish. If you're missing fish, it's not always your fault. Sometimes the fish miss it. And they're just hitting it to get it away out of their zone. But let the fish have it for a good 1/1000th, 2/1000th, count to 2 seconds. Or until you see the line moving, or you reel in until you feel weight, then set hook. But if you're doing that and you're missing fish, which I know Cody and my friend Alex went to come out on the midday topwater bass fishing video. They both took 7 tries to get their first fish. And I don't think that's all on them. They're both pretty good fishermen. And I was using the scum frog and I was getting them nearly every time.
First frog fish,
let's go.
How many hits did it take to get that one fish?
7.
On your 7th try, you got it.
Change the frog up.
The first fish you got on that, or the first hit you got on that frog.
And the reasoning was, the hooks on the scum frog are parallel and almost nearly pointed out. And on like a frog like this, the spro pop, those hooks are pointed inwards very slightly. They're inverted, and that helps with being more weedless. You don't get caught up as easily. But at the same time, the hookup ratio drops, I feel, significantly enough for me to bend my hooks out. Like on the scum frog, it came with the same thing too. They were bent inwards, and I bent them out with the pliers. And I found this to be really bad on the live target sunfish. Those hooks are inverted very heavily.
Oh, there he was. I didn't get him hookup stuck there.
And these are really strong hooks, so it's kind of hard to fix. Another tip is looking at the length of the tails. See, the tails here are significantly longer. It's about 1/2 inch. And what I would actually do is clip this down to nearly there. So the shorter you cut these legs, they're not gonna bite back here and miss it. They're gonna bite up here more on the frog instead of just the tails, and that may be why you're missing the fish. So those are just some quick tips. Can't believe I got that done in only one shoot. Here will be some fishing clips just the other day, Cody and I fishing. He should be in some videos soon. He just needs to stop working full time.
I watched Deadpool again. That's so funny. I read it in the...
Yeah. Oh, you snapped me off too, so that's great. There. See? Just calm down, bud. Let's get the release. I usually pull a fish off of this dock. That was a hit.
Yeah.
No, jig. He wants to jump in the kayak. That was a good one. It's probably 16 and a half or so. And he choked that swim jig. Wow. Oh, that's a good one too. Barely hooked. There we go.